Right, so let's go to the custom units where I was before. We've got the Starks with the leader, Robb Stark, and his subordinates. He's got Catelyn, he's got, let's go to the officers. We've got Robb Stark, we've got Catelyn, his mother. We've got Great John Umbar, who's going to be like his marshal. And you've got Roderick Castle. You guys must know him. He's the one that guided Lady Catelyn around when she was trying to find out who attempted to murder Bran. Roderick Castle's a good guy, so I had to put him in there. He taught Robb and Jon Snow basically everything they know about fighting, so I have to obviously make him a badass as well. As you can see from his stats, he's got quite balanced out stats. He can use bow and arrows, he can use his swords and all that, but I'm not talking too much about Roderick Castle here. And you've got Wendell Manderly. He's more of a book character. He's quite an important character that helped out Robb Starks during the beginning of the War of the Five Kings. He's more of a book character. I've got a lot of book characters. So book purists, A Song of Ice and Fire purists will enjoy this. I've got Mollen. I can't remember his first name. I think Hallis, I'm not sure. Mollen is one of the book characters. He's quite an important character. These are all Robb's bannermen from when he decided to raise his banners against the Lannisters when they kidnapped his sisters and they killed Ned Stark. This is Daisy Mormont. I believe she's a nephew. I believe she's a niece of Jorah or Jeor Mormont. Jorah Mormont is obviously Daenerys's. Right now on a TV show, she's banished him, but she's Jorah is Daenerys's, you know, right hand man. And I think she's either his niece or I believe she's his niece, or maybe a cousin, I'm not sure. We've got Small John Umbar, who I believe he's the son of Great John Umbar. He's either the son or the nephew. I think he's his son or younger brother. I think he's his son. Small John Umbar is Great John Umbar's son, and he's called Small John, but he's huge himself. That's what's interesting about the character. If you book purists will know that I've made him look quite a lot like his book counterpart, with his red hair and everything. And you got Robin Flint. He's obviously a bannerman for Robb Stark. And you got Talisa Stark, the lady that confused, distracted, and just about fucked up Robb from his mission to destroy the Lannisters in the TV show. Obviously in the books she's Jane Westerling, but I decided to use Talisa because she's more recognisable and more of you guys just have more fun of her, seeing her about in this huge war I'm going to set up soon. And then that's just the Starks. And then you've got the Carr Starks. I'm going to go through this a bit quicker now because it's taking too long. You've got the Carr Stark. This is Rickard Carr Stark. He's an important figure for the Starks. And you've got his sons, Torrin, I think, Carr Stark. And that's Eddard Carr Stark. And then there's Mage Mormont. I put her in the Carr Stark unit. She's the mother of Daisy Mormont, you saw earlier. And then you've got Galbert Glover. He's the younger brother of Robert Glover, Robert Glover. Robert Glover's quite a big character from the books. And then you've got Harrion Carr Stark, the oldest Carr Stark son. These Carr Stark sons were killed by Jaime Lannister in the TV show. And Rickard Carr Stark wanted revenge by killing, and he wanted to kill the younger cousin Lannisters. So he got his revenge and he got his head cut off for it in this show, but yeah, let's not go into all that right now. And then you got Lucas Blackwood. He's more of a book character. He got killed during the Red Wedding in the books, but he looks pretty cool in the books, so I thought I'd put him in there. He's part of the, you know, Stark bannermen. And you got some soldiers here, just some random soldiers here. I think they're Stark men. And then you got people loyal to the Starks. As I was explaining before, the people loyal to the Starks are people that started off on, either started off with the Starks, or they ended up being put into Frey camps or Bolton camps. And when the Freys and the Boltons decided to turn on Robb Stark, they still stayed loyal. So they were captured or they managed to escape and try and find their way back to Robb Stark, or they just stayed loyal. And this is Robb Glover. He's quite a big character in the books from what I've read. And he's the older brother of Galbert Glover. And he basically has to fight for the Boltons at some... He starts off with Robb, but then he gets sent to the fight for the, with the Boltons. And then when Roose Bolton decided to revolt against Robb Stark and basically betray Robb, Robb Glover still stood strong and still wanted to fight for Robb. So, Robb Stark, that is. Robb A. Glover. So Robb A. Glover decided to just kind of, I think he got captured at one point. He got captured by the Freys or the Boltons or someone. And I think he's still captured in the books right now, but I'm not sure. But he's a badass character anyway. He's on his own little mission. I think he's managed to escape actually in the books, and he's on his own little mission right now in the books to liberate Starks or something, whatever's left of the Starks. Yeah, so anyway. Then you got Willis Manderly. He's the father of the other Manderly that you saw in the other Stark unit. He comes in and helps. He's a Stark bannerman and helps Stark out. You got Major Serwin, another Stark man. You got Kyle Condon, all these that work underneath Robb A. Glover and Willis Manderly and all that. You got Ronald Stout, Tallheart, and Stevron Frey. Stevron Frey is a Frey that was loyal to the Starks. He died before the Red Wedding thing happened. But everyone knows, everyone says that if he had stayed alive before the Red Wedding happened, he would have been very against it. And Oliver Frey is another Frey loyal to the Starks. He is Robb Stark's... It's basically what Podrick does. He's Robb Stark's Podrick, basically. And he's very loyal to Robb. He's older than Robb in the books by 2 years. But he's very loyal to Robb. And, you know, he didn't really have a face, so I kind of created him out of the other Freys and... what I could think what he could look like. And Malister, he's just a Malister, isn't he? I don't know much about him. You know, he's just apart from the fact that he's a Malister, he's a big Stark, he's a Stark soldier. So then you've got the Lannisters, you've got Joffrey, of course, he's the king of the Lannister area. You've got Cersei, you've got Jaime, head of the Kingsguard. You've got Vlar, he's just a Lannister guardsman. You got Sansa. See, I put Sansa Stark in the Lannisters because at this moment in time where I'm starting this scenario, Sansa's been captured. So, you know, she's basically like having to deal with Joffrey's torturous punishments and you know, just torturous douchebag bullshit that he does. So that's, you just gotta, you know, use your imagination there. Even if somehow, let's say I decide to pick the Starks. And I bump into Sansa and she's trying to attack me. Just ignore that. But we're trying to rescue her. And you can actually do that. You can't rescue her, but you can recruit her from the Lannisters if you defeat them. So yeah, hopefully we can save Sansa at some point. Depending on who I pick, I might even pick the Lannisters, so I don't know. But we've got Boris Blunt. He's another Kingsguard member. You see him more in the books. You hear about him more in the books. Got Meryn Trance, the person Arya's been dying to kill. It's one of her people on her kill list. Meryn Trance has been a regular on the show, and he's quite a big character in the books too. The Hound, of course, looks pretty good, doesn't he? He's a big guy, big dude. He's part of King Joffrey's Kingsguard. Then you got Greenfield, another one from the books. He's part of King Joffrey's Kingsguard. Got Mandan Moore, he's supposed to be like this very stern-faced, you know, serious Kingsguard member from the books. And then you've got Tyrion, who's the head of the Small Council, Gralt, and this is still part of Joffrey's army. Got Tyrion Lannister, Podrick Payne, you know, you all know Podrick. Bronn, you guys like that? That's Bronn, yeah. Littlefinger, he's going to be a sneaky arsehole. Calm traitor there, this is way of life. Varys, looks alright, doesn't it? The Pyromancer, the guy that helps Tyrion with the wildfire. I gave him bombs as a weapon, that's pretty clever. You got Illyn Payne, the guy who chopped Ned Stark's head off by the orders of Joffrey. And you got Aerys Oakheart, who got sent to Dorne with Marcella, so he can look after Marcella in Dorne. But then Arianne Martell in the books seduced him. and he got fucked over. And you got Lancel Lannister, who right now has been an utter douchebag of the High Sparrows in the TV show. But this is Lancel before that, when Robert Baratheon used to take a piss out of him and be like, Lancel Lannister.